Hi guys, I am Bhairavi. I am a visual development artist and an illustrator. Welcome to my channel. I started this channel a few months ago to share some tips and techniques I have learned about art and being an artist over the last few years, and also share my progress as I continue to learn. So welcome. Last weekend, I went with my husband to Bodega Bay here in California to do some weekend painting while he did his photography. So I thought this would be a great opportunity for me to share some tips on how to paint landscapes with you guys. So let's get right to it. My very first tip would be to just have some color in the background. Get rid of that super intimidating plain white background. At least that's where I start. The color you pick really doesn't matter, according to me, because you end up painting over it. Next, I like to use my hands to make a little frame to kind of roughly gauge what my composition is going to be. What that does is it helps to eliminate all of these other things in the background that can be distracting. So you just focus on your frame when you're painting. And once you're done with that, you can just do like a very rough drawing of what goes where, right? So that gives you an idea of your composition and you make a clear focal point. The next thing is when you're painting a landscape outside, don't feel like you have to put in everything you see just the way you see it. Be very selective, especially when you're starting your painting. There are a lot of quick decisions to be made. So be selective, see what works with the scene, and absolutely don't hesitate to rearrange the elements or honestly even leave something out. It's very important to simplify and eliminate any distractions. If something feels too busy, simplify it. For me, the easiest way to do this is grouping shapes together. I think that really helps. So when I say shapes, I mean, you know, shadow shapes that form, or if you see a bush or a big bunch of trees, combining their shape together kind of really helps simplifying it. When you're just starting your painting, don't worry too much about the details, and also like put in the details only if you absolutely need to. The very first thing to do would be to establish the basic shapes, the colors that you see. Define the light and shadow, because when you're painting outside, you have limited time. You don't want to spend too much time on the details in the beginning, and especially when the light is constantly changing, when you're painting outdoors, you want to establish everything first. So get all the basics on your canvas first and then worry about details. That is if you really want to. Also, don't be too afraid to change the elements in your composition as you go. If something doesn't seem to work, eliminate it, like I did here. In the beginning, I had a larger vertical rock in the foreground, but then as I proceeded with my painting, it didn't really fit with me. So I just completely eliminated that bit. So when you're painting, a few things to keep in mind is the atmospheric perspective. Remember, as things go further away from you, they almost fade out a little bit. Another way to do that is have a little more detail in the foreground and the middle ground versus the background. Don't forget to vary your greens. The lighting that you're working in affects your colors a lot. So don't just stick to one generic green. Experiment with the greens. There are a lot of greens in nature, so don't just stick to one. And most of all, remember to have fun. Remember, every painting that you do is going to offer a new set of challenges, and that'll be a great learning experience. So keep painting. The more you practice, the more you will get the hang of it. Learn from your mistakes, paint, and repeat.
Thanks for watching the video, you guys. I hope you found my tips helpful, and I hope it inspires and motivates you all to go outside and paint. It's fun, And don't forget to check out my last week's video where I share some ideas on what to draw when you don't know what to draw. So thank you guys for being here. If you want to see more of my artwork, come follow me on Instagram. I am sharing my everyday updates there and I would love to have you guys there. So I'll see you all back here next week. Bye and happy painting!